Bring back happy holidays to everyone joining us. Thank you all so much. What a night of action here in Ontario, California. I want to introduce a man who looked impressive tonight with a destructive 11th round stoppage over Tony Harrison. His hometown of Houston, Texas should be very proud of what he was able to do tonight. Continues to evolve and grow. He said he was going to once again become the champion. Lo and behold, he did it once again. The WBC Super Welterweight Champion of the World from Houston, Texas, Jermell Charlo. Lions Only is in the building.
Appreciate it. Thank you. I know the last time I was here, I was hurt feelings and shit. You know what I'm saying?
Man, let's give it up for Tony Harrison. I love seeing the respect Tony Harrison is the champion. He fought his butt off. And Jermell, before we go to you, I want to introduce Tony and then we'll get to the both of you. But Tony Harrison in Detroit should be very proud of this man as well. What a performance from Tony Harrison, gracious in defeat. Tony, we'll get to comments from you, but first we will give it to the champion, Jermell Charlo, with his esteemed trainer, Derek James. His uncle, his family is here as well. Jermell, the floor is yours. Opening comments on how you feel after recapturing the WBC Super Welterweight Championship of the World.
I mean, the feeling is ecstatic. It's not normal. I know when he won the title, it wasn't normal for him. Just getting it back. I've been here before, I won it before. And Tony put up a hell of a fight, you know what I'm saying? He had a game plan, and he listened to his people. I had a game plan, I listened to my people. Despite all the shit talk, you know, he a funny dude, you know what I mean? I started enjoying the shit, just listening to him, that's fucking crazy. I really got something going on, you know what I mean? But, you know, we boxers, we all say each other crazy. I mean, shit on the outside, well, we all can. Well, respect to any man getting in the ring. It's not easy.
Tony, open your comments.
Fuck my life, man. Fuck my life. You know, I don't think other people understand how much I put into that shit, man. You know what I mean? But, you know, being off a year, man, coming to get somebody that fucking tough and strong, you know what I mean? Like, we had a game plan, and, you know, the first time we fought him, we boxed him. He came out so fucking wild this time. And it wasn't even like nobody's like that much stronger than the next. But it's just like, for me, I feel like my game plan had to switch. Like I said, I'm good at adapting. And I told myself, like in my mind, fuck what my father was saying. I'm like, you got to dog the dog. And that's the way I had to put it today. I'm like, shit, fuck it. I mean, if you gonna go out, go out. But you got to dog the dog. He was the dog. Everybody in the world considered him a dog. I feel like I pushed him back every round. I feel like I was comfortable. But it's boxing, man, and when you're going to get somebody like that, you can't be, like, lax 1 second or one round, and that's what happened, man. You know, I got lax for 1 second or one round. He hooked, I hooked, his shit was a little shorter. I didn't see it, and it just kind of knocked me off balance, man. Kind of stunned me a little bit. I pushed Jack Reese off because I didn't want him to stop it. I'd rather go out a little harder than that, but, you know, Jack is championship referee, man. You know, cool. The bitch earned it, man. I made sure the motherfucker earned it. Like, I'm like, I can't get this bitch back like this, not this easy. So I just had to push, man, but damn, man, hurt me, man. I need this one bad as fuck. Like, I wanted this bitch, like, my whole life. I would've, damn. He killed it, man, but hey, he earned it, man. Like, ain't nothing I can say, man to man. Like, you know what I'm saying? I dog him if I need to dog him, or if you know some whole shit, but... My shit, man, he earned that shit today.
No,
ain't nothing
else to say. I know where Charlo, like, I don't like all that
stuff. And want to acknowledge real quick, Jermell Charlo, the brother of Jermell in the house, the champion supporting his brother once again, the champion. Great to see Jermell. Also, Thomas Hitman Hearns from Detroit, the Hall of Famer. And supporter Tony Harrison. Were you not entertained tonight? As we will open it up to the media for more questions.
I think we definitely have fight of the year.
Good shit, bro. Good shit.
You put up a fight.
Hey, Jermell, you had two great knockdowns, man. How are you feeling after that first knockdown and then the second?
I mean, like I said, I'm always surprised whenever I drop somebody. I'm not, definitely know I pack a different type of punch, very heavy hands. And I was excited, you know what I mean? I went out there for the kill, thinking I could get it early. I knocked some guys out in the first round before, so it's like, could have ended the night short earlier, but it's a tough dude, tough individual.
Right here, guys. Champ, congratulations
on getting your title back. Tell us exactly what was going through your mind as you went into deep waters. Do you feel like that you had to make a statement at the latter part of the fight, and did you hurt you at any point?
I know I have to step it up. I never got it in that fight. You know, Tony threw some solid shots, but you know, when you do gotta get later in the rounds, it's when the willpower gotta come in, play a major effect. And like I said, it was tough, you know what I'm saying? Not a lot of people, I don't know how many people in this room, you know, go 12 and it's just banging, you know what I mean? I had a lot to prove, so did he, so it's, you know, it's a different type of war.
About how close did you feel it was on the cards when you were going into the 11th round?
I don't know. I really wouldn't. I was just in it. You know what I mean? I really wasn't. I was letting my coach. I definitely felt like maybe he got maybe a few rounds. I know the early knockdown helps speed up the scorecard for me, but I know he did. You know, have some good rounds. You know what I mean? And that's boxing.
Before we get to the next question, the scorecards at the time of the stoppage, 96-93 on two scorecards in favor of Charlo, 95-94 for one to Harrison. So that was the scorecards at the time of the stoppage. Mike?
Hi, Harrison, Jamel. After all the controversy in the first fight, I felt you won. How good did it feel to remove the judges from the equation?
You know, that was the all-around goal. You know, I wanted to score the knockout, you know. And, you know, all the shit he was talking, everything that he was saying, and it just led and built, you know, was building up. And, hey, that's the initial goal. That's what I wanted. Got it. It's felt exciting.
Do you think you're going to get a unification in 2020?
It's a great possibility. You know, I am a promoter. I can't say that, you know. But I got people, advisors, and people ahead of me to control some of those things. If the 154 pound division, I'm steering the wheel.
Jamel, as a fighter, do you have some kind of closure coming back to winning in that fashion? If there was ever any doubt in your mind at all?
I got a lot on my shoulders. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't necessarily a closure. I got a lot more to handle in business, particularly in the weight division. I know probably a big question is, would you do a trilogy? That's throughout everything, but take that shit to pay-per-view. This could have easily been pay-per-view, you know what I mean? And Ontario did great. They showed up. Fox did an amazing job with promoting and all of the things that, you know, we've seen. Hey, it's whatever.
You guys did even better when promoting yourself.
Yeah. Good
chemistry.
You could be a promoter,
I promise you. Jermell, question for both of you. Jermell, you know, with all the talk that came into this fight, people even questioning your mental strength, your mental fortitude, does this feel sweeter than winning in any other championship fight? And for Tony,
I'm going to ask a question, then ask him a
question. Go ahead,
Jermell. You know, that's what I was trying to tell y'all, that mental BS is like, you know, I guess that was part of his game plan. I'm different. I'm a warrior, you know what I'm saying? I'm in a different ball field when it comes out of that mental. So I've been through so much, like that's nothing, this is little to me. I'm just entertaining you guys, and hopefully you guys can, you know, continue to enjoy me and my brother as long as we, you know, sit on the throne as in the boxing world. You know, it's, the mental thing is something that any boxer that steps in the ring, you can go 12 rounds, you better be mentally prepared for any and everything.
Did all of that make it tonight the sweetest victory of your career, though?
You know, sweetest victory again. Yeah, it was sweet. Thank you.
And Tony, also, you know, fought a great fight tonight. You launched, you know, one of the best verbal assaults, you know, in the lead up to a fight. Is it more bitter than any other defeat, being that you wanted this one so bad and everything that was coming into this fight?
I mean, nothing before this fight really mattered, man. I keep telling you, you know, how I felt was how I felt. But nothing for me was more important than winning the fight. You know, he fought his heart out, I fought mine out, man. That's the name of the sport, man. You know, I guess I've been saying this for the longest, Saturday night, that the fans will win. The fans will win. I was going to make sure that the fans were going to get something, you know, that they wanted. They're going to get their money worth.
Tony, seemed like you were taunting Jermell after he threw a few combinations, and you were having fun in there. Do you think you got a little bit irresponsible defensively?
Man, that's what happened. But you know what, man? Like, when you're going to get somebody that's top tier, like, this ain't no scrub. You know what I mean? Like, he not, like, no bum or nothing like that. Like, that's the thing. Like, in no way in the boxing match, it's not basketball, it's no way in the boxing match that you could find lax in any part of any round, man, and you know, it just showed, you know. I felt like I was doing whatever I really wanted to do before that, and I felt like certain parts of the round, I felt like I started breaking his will, you know what I mean, because he started coming forward, and I told myself, like, look, you tough, you know what I mean, you strong, just go for it, let's see him fighting on his back foot, and I made him do that damn near the whole night. I was catching a lot of his shots, and I pushed forward, man, but he earned, like, ain't nothing else to say, man. He earned it, man. Ain't nothing else I can really say. The guy earned it. He was a champion for a reason. He earned it.
Last question, man.
Hey, Jermell, it seems like this time around you concentrated a little more to the body than the first fight.
He hit me with some good body shots, too, but let me tell you that. He hit me with one. Like, he didn't even see that I had my poker face on. I was like, ooh.
was that something that... you concentrated on a little bit more this time around in camp and leading into the fight, since you didn't go as much to the body the first time around?
Well, I mean, this fight was, you know, the fight to show the world, like, you know, I don't know if y'all too many of y'all new faces following me, but me and my brother, I'm a boxer, you know, I was a guy that stick move and move around the ring and did those type of things. I know this in New York, I think he's from New York. He's paid attention when I fought in D.C. Against Rosado, I moved, you know, I was a boxer, move around, stick and move. And then, you know, me and Derrick James recommended some things and walking boys down. And it just, and Tyson influenced my game and made me much better. So, you know, you got to be able to, you know, being a champion, you got to be able to do the things that you learned your whole career. I know, you know, I could tell Tony been working with some vets like Hearns himself and his father. He boxed before. I don't know if y'all remember his father. He was a welterweight contender, major guy up there. And you could see the age in a fighter. You know what I mean? And, you know, I brought out some things. You know, I brought out more than just that old stock walk down type of fighter. Tony went to come forward. Oh, okay, come forward. So I could set some traps. So I came forward, nagged up, threw some body shots, and just try to do as much as I can to win that fight. I knew I was getting close. I didn't want it to get close. I knew there was some late rounds that he was edging, you know what I mean? And I didn't want it to be, you know, that wicked feeling again, you know what I mean? So I looked over at my brother, glanced over at him, seeing him only one moving in the crowd at that moment. He was communicating with me with that twin shit. So. And it was time to step it up.
All right. Thank you.
All right, guys.